Arrah!
I know, the Mexican music doesn't sound so good in the light of what's going on in terms of this H1, N1, out one flu situation that we have right now in the United States. But we're trying to make the best of a bad situation here today. It's Randy Miller for Kathy and Judy here on WGN. And it's time for the first ever flu mask fashion show. We've got our contestants gathered here this morning. And really, I mean, it's they're so good. Steve, have you seen these folks out here?
I can see some of them, yeah. Oh, impressive.
Very impressive. I mean, they've decorated their masks. They've gone to great lengths. They've all got their ensemble, not just the mask, but they've got the entire ensemble there. And this is what they get. We get a 3 nights accommodations in a standard room at the Allegro Playa Car Occidental Hotel in Cancun. Round trip airfare for two to Cancun, departing from Chicago O'Hare Airport. All meals and drinks at the resort under the all-inclusive plan. And the trip must be taken in either September or October 2009 and is subject to hotel and airline availability, blackout dates, and scheduling policies. But I think when you travel to Mexico, you're always subject to blackout dates. Anyway, it is based on originality, creativity. I'm the final judge. I want to meet the contestants right now. First of all, Doug. Is Doug here? Where's Doug? All right. Doug, how you doing?
Doing great, thanks.
Now, you've got the whole Cubs package going there, Doug. Describe your outfit.
Well, it's just a Cubs sweatshirt bought a couple years ago, my hat, and couldn't find a surgical mask, so I had to cut up a golf towel to do this.
But you know what? It works, doesn't it? I mean, I think that's effective.
It works, and I hope it brings some luck today.
Yeah, I hope so, too. That's really good. Good job. All right, what about – oh, and Doug, let me ask you, why would you want to go to Mexico? Now, you're not afraid to go to Mexico. You're not – you're feeling pretty good about the trip?
It's going to be cold here, then. I wish I'd just get away from all the cold.
And who would you take with you?
I'd take my wife and daughter. And, I paid for my daughter, of course.
Okay, and where are you from?
Barrington.
All right. And did anybody see this ensemble before you presented it to us today?
Only my daughter. My wife swore she'd divorce me if she saw it.
Okay, we won't tell her you're here. What about, is Ron here? Ron is from Lakemoor, and Ron is, he's got a pig nose there. Hi, Ron.
Good morning. How are you?
Tell us about your outfit.
Well, I went to a craft store, picked out this pig nose, and actually got a real doctor's mask and glued it on. And actually comes with a runny nose, so...
He's actually squirting water out of his pig nose. That's pretty good. It looks like you're wearing pantyhose on your face.
No, it's actually a doctor's mask. I try to paint it as close to my skin and nose color as possible.
Can we see the water come out again?
Sure. Huh?
Look at this. That is so good, man. Nice job.
Thank you.
Now, who are you going to take with you to Mexico if you win?
There's several people I could probably take. Yeah. I haven't made up a final decision yet.
My wish is that if you win the contest, that you wear the pig nose when you get to Mexico.
I'll actually bring in the swine flu with me.
Yeah, that's right. It just squirt the... He's squirting his water. I hope that's water. Yeah, out of his nostrils, pig nostrils. That is great. What about Kelly? Is Kelly here? Kelly is from Chicago. Hi, Kelly.
Hello.
Kelly, you okay? The bride to be. There you go.
Yes, I'm the pig bride.
You're the pig bride. Now I can't really see the mask. Okay, you got the pig nostril, you got the pig nose too. But you're wearing a wedding dress.
Yes. Well, it's I'm going to wear this for my rehearsal dinner, but I put a veil over a pig snout, which was handmade, so.
You know what? You make a beautiful pig bride.
Oh, thank you.
You're the most beautiful pig bride I've seen today.
Thank you very much.
That is fantastic. Now, you're the person that called that would want this for your honeymoon, right?
Yes, we are. Or, you know, romantic getaway. We're just looking to, obviously, with this tough economy, I mean, trying to go to Mexico for free would be awesome. You know, we're paying for so much.
Yeah, right. What's your name? What's your fiance's name?
Kevin, and he's here, actually, too.
Oh, he is?
He's over there.
Does he? Oh, he's wearing a pig nose, too. Oh, no, he's not. I'm sorry.
Actually, we did make one for him, but we didn't model it because he only had one.
That is awesome. Great outfit.
Thank you.
All right. How about, is it Patty? Is Patty here? Hi, Patty.
Hola.
Patty DeWeer is here. Patty's from Highland. Indiana.
Hi.
I'm not exactly sure what you are. Can you describe your outfit?
This is to make sure nothing gets through because, you know, with the paper ones, they say that some of the spores can still get through.
Yeah, you've actually got like a gas mask, don't you?
Yeah, and I have, so my drink goes right through, so nothing can contaminate my drink while I'm in Mexico on the beach.
So you've got some tubing attached to the gas mask, no other particles can get through there, is that right?
Right, that's right.
Wow, I've never seen, is that more of a colostomy bag, or what is that?
No, not quite.
That is fantastic, I love that. And then you've got the shirt that says what?
It says, this little piggy went to Mexico.
And you get a little piggy that's hanging on your shirt.
And he's got his mask on, and it says, eat beef.
And that's like, it's really like a gas mask, isn't it?
Yeah.
Wow, so you are totally protected.
Totally.
And a little scary, to be honest with you. But that is great stuff. Who would you take with you to Mexico?
My husband, Jeff.
And does he also have a gas mask? Or,
yes,
or is that the reason you have a gas mask?
Yeah, he's got one, too. We can be Twinkies on the beach.
All right, let's see. Carol... Is it Carol?
Yeah, hi, how are you?
Carol Braun is here from North Riverside, Illinois, to compete in the first ever flu mask fashion show here on WGN. Carol, what are you, you're all decorated everywhere.
Well, I have all my little pigs, they're in a blanket.
Uh-huh.
And all my little pigs have masks on as well as I do.
Right.
And I'm not afraid to go to Mexico because by September or October, nobody's going to remember this
No,
at all.
Absolutely. They'll say, what were we all concerned about, right?
Correct.
That really looks good, though. Now, what kind of a, you get the pigs in a blanket, but that's like a Mexican.
It's a Mexican blanket.
A Mexican blanket, yeah.
Yeah.
And then you've got the snout.
The snout.
Yeah.
And I got my pig on my sombrero.
You got a pig sticking out of your sombrero.
Correct.
That's really
and
good.
My
Mexico or bust on the back of that.
Uh-huh.
And now let me ask you this. Who would you take to Mexico?
My daughter.
Your daughter would go to Mexico?
Yes.
All right. So she's not embarrassed that you're here this morning?
She's always embarrassed by me, but
yeah.
All right. Yeah.
All right. Well, here's what I'm going to ask you guys to do, because I want to get a very good look at you for the judging here, okay? We're going to take a break. When we come back, I want you to parade up and down Michigan Avenue here. Oh, we got one more?
Hello, how you doing? I'm Dennis from Montgomery.
Hey, Dennis, how are you?
Real good, and you?
Dennis, you're scary.
Yes, I am.
What? Dennis Jorgensen from Montgomery. And Dennis, now what is it that you have on your face?
I went with the simple skull drawing.
You got the skull mask.
That's right.
Flu mask.
That's right.
That's pretty good.
Thanks.
Now, that's, you know, I mean, right now people are scared of anybody with a flu mask anyway, but they would run from you.
I want them to.
And who would you take with you to Mexico?
I would take my wife, Erica. We've been married 10 years next month. Haven't been on a honeymoon yet.
Oh, man, it would be perfect.
So we're getting ready to go to Mexico for
perfect
you guys.
Timing, yeah. That is great.
That's right.
You got some tattoos going there, too. Are
I
those
do,
real,
yeah.
Or is it just for the contest?
Oh, I've had them.
And he's wearing a shirt that says "World's Greatest Dad."
I am. Yeah.
That's
my daughter said good luck. So.
That's a funny thing. You know, he's got this scary mask and a "World's Greatest Dad" shirt.
That's right.
That's really. You guys look fantastic. I want to thank all of you for
coming down.
You really look good. And so, in a minute, we'll take a break. In a minute, just one by one, we're going to have you parade up and down Michigan Avenue here in front of the Showcase Studios, so we can get a good judging view.
All right,
okay.
Let's do it.
Why are you guys out here today?
Well, basically, we're getting married in September, and we're looking for a way to hopefully travel and, you know, especially with the swine flu, we're trying to show that, you know, you shouldn't be afraid to do things and, you know, that things, you know, stay positive, and we would be so appreciative for it.
What are your plans so far without the travel factored in?
Well, we have the Hall of the Church booked.
So I'll DJ photographer, those are in the works.
We're working on everything, so we're just trying to budget.